my husband and I took a course in Florida. It was a tantra course. It was a Tai Chi tantra course. And she gave us that to do for homework. And I'm a sexual educator. And we had never done that before.
Yeah.
And it was scary for me. But it was super hot at the same time. It was scary but hot.
Yeah.
But what was fun about it was I got to observe him and he got to observe me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's, it was so cool to see how he did it and how I did it. Mm-hmm. So that we could pleasure each other that way. And you can after that, try to pleasure each other the way they did it and say, hey, am I like a little to the left, a little to the right, a little faster, a little slower? Like have a play night where you can do that.
Yeah.
You know, obviously you can't do that when you're dating at the very beginning, but you know, you can after a while. You can ask for what you want. And if you're not ready, if you're not ready to ask for what you want sexually, don't have sex yet.
Right.
Like wait until you're ready and comfortable to talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
You're obviously not close enough if you're not ready to ask for what you want.
And I think that's part of the trickiness with first time sex, and especially in hookup culture and stuff like that, is that there, a lot of the time you've probably known that person for maybe an hour. Like, while I said 55% and 4% both seem low, it's actually a miracle that anybody gets off like at all, because a lot of the time alcohol or drugs are also involved and you're like, how is it anything happening here other than people just like slapping their skin against each other? Like,
and there could be some faking orgasms happening.
I'm sure there are.
Yeah.
And again, that goes, the whole idea of fake orgasms is fascinating in and of itself because again, like I have read about this happening, but I would imagine the percentage of men faking their orgasm versus women is probably pretty skewed. Like, the idea of faking orgasms is almost exclusively relegated to women, and the idea that women are the ones who will do that, like even from like the famous like Harry Met Sally scene, and I can't
I'll have whatever she's having.
Yeah, like the number of movies that and TV shows and stuff that make the joke about that.
Right,
it's like, well, yeah, of course I was faking, like you thought. And that to me is super interesting because sometimes it's about, and especially in hookup culture and stuff, you want the other person to feel good, but it's that sense that like, don't you want them to want you to feel good too?
Yes, exactly. Like, that's exactly the point.
And that's, and I know Dr. Lori Mintz gets into this, but that is the pleasure gap. It's this idea that this exists for a reason.
Yes.
And a lot of them are social and cultural, and like it can be complicated, but a lot of it also comes back to people not knowing how to communicate what they need and what they want.
And not taking their time.
Right, and not taking their time.
Right.
Like,
And if you are, you do want to have hookup sex, like talk about it. Like, you want to have fun while you're having first time hookup sex, if that's what your goal is.
Yeah.
Then ask for what you want. Like,